Good afternoon, everyone. Well, good evening. Thank you for joining tonight's session. We want to give it around 5 more minutes just for everybody to be able to enter into the room and join. So give us a few more moments and we'll be starting promptly at 6:05. Thank you.
Funny how money changes situation. Miscommunication lead to complication. My emancipation don't fit your equation. I was on the humble, you on every station. Someone play young Lauren like she done. But remember not to game the one of the sun. Everything you did has already been done. I know all the tricks from bricks to Kingston. My ting done, major king done, one wrong. Now understand El Boogie, not violent. But if a thing test me, run to my gun. Can't take a threat to me, newborn son. Been this way since creation. A groupie call you far from temptation. Now you want ball over separation. Tarnish my image in the conversation. Who you gonna scrimmage like you the champion? You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. Now, how come your talk turned cold? Gain the whole world for the price of your soul. Grab hold of what you can't control. Now you all lost for the sight to behold. Wisdom is better than silver and gold. I was hopeless, now I'm on hope roll. Every man wanna act like he's exempt. Need to get down on his knees and repent. Can't slick talk on the day of judgment. The movement's similar to a serpent. Try to play straight, how your whole style been? Consequences, no coincidence. Hypocrites always wanna play innocent. Always wanna take it to the full out extent. Always wanna make it seem like good intent. Never wanna face it when it's time for punishment. I know you don't wanna hear my opinion. There come many paths and you must choose one. And if you don't change, then the rain soon comes. So you might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just won one. You might win some, but you just lost one. Law. What you throw out, come back to you star. Never underestimate those who you scar. Cause comma, come back to you hard. You can't hold God, people back that long. The chain of shade time wasn't made that strong. Trying to pretend like your word is your bomb. But until you do right, all you do will go wrong. Now some might mistake this for just a simple song. And some don't know what they had till it's gone. Now even when you're gone, you can still be reborn. And from the night can arrive the sweet dawn. Now some might listen and some might shine. And some may think that they reach perfection. If you look closely, you'll see what you become. Cause you might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one.
You might win some, but you really lost one. You just lost one. It's so silly.
Thank you everyone for joining us tonight for the Live Your Life Wellness session. Tonight's session is sponsored by New York City Council Majority Leader Lori Cumbo out of Brooklyn's 35th District. And I'm from Brooklyn, so I'm gonna shout out the 35th District right now, Fort Greene, Clinton Hill, Prospect Heights, Crown Heights, and Bed-Stuy. So if you're from the area, Come on, y'all. We throwing up the Bed-Stuy, do or die. You guys know how it is. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We are ready to have a great session. I can't thank you enough for joining with us. My name is Sandrine Blake. I'm the Assistant Director of Events with AmidaCare Health Insurance. AmidaCare is a Medicaid-designated health plan providing care for people who live with or are placed at elevated risk for HIV. AmidaCare recognizes that staying healthy is way more than just going to your doctor's appointments and taking medication. We focus on the whole person and we work to address all aspects that impact a person's life, like housing and health and healthy food. So right now, sorry about that, guys. So right now, this session is part of our Live Your Life Wellness Program, and this just promotes wellness throughout the month. And we are so happy to be joined by the awesome team of Reforum Consulting today, who will be bringing us some awesome information and wellness tips. Before we do everything, guys, check the chat because there's going to be some instructions dropping in, like introduce yourself and answer today's icebreaker questions. Your name, Sandrine, your location, Brooklyn. Wow. What's your self-care? I like to shop. I wanted to put eat, but I didn't want to get penalized, but I wanted to say a nice cake every now and then is good for
this
me.
This is judgment-free.
This is right, completely judgment-free, because I was on the same mind frame, but yeah, I went with my sleep meditation. So we're on the same page.
Awesome. And then I do like to take some quiet time for myself just to relax. So right now I'm going to pass it over to the awesome team at Reforum Consulting to take it away for today's event. Guys, we're going to need to grab some items for today's workshop and I'll put it in the chat for you guys right now.
So hi everyone, welcome and happy Thursday. Thanks for being here on this snowy cold day. Let's get together and warm up and talk about our resiliency, right? So just to introduce ourselves, we are Reforum Consulting. We are a training, coaching, and professional development firm. And we go in and we have conversations around mental health and wellness with different organizations as well as companies, so that we can really start to break the stigma around mental health and wellness. We've been in operation for about 2 years now. We've done plenty of workshops with AmidaCare. So we're just excited to be here tonight, excited to bring some more knowledge when it comes to our wellness and our health. I'm sorry. I missed something.
She just was popping in.
So we're just here, Reform Consulting, and we're going to be working tonight to really talk about our moment of clarity, something that I think we all pretty much need at this particular time. And before we get into that conversation, I'm going to introduce my two lovely co-workers, colleagues, co-founders, best friends, travel buddies. I can't get enough of these women. Yvania Smith and Tommy Getz, and just introduce yourself to the people.
Hello, hello, everyone. I am Javanya, and I am looking forward to being in community with y'all tonight. So thank you for having us, and thank you for being here.
Hello, happy Thursday. I'm Tymie Gazdin. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and I'm happy to be in the space. The music definitely bumped up my vibe some, you know. It's snowy outside. I wouldn't kind of go snuggle in my bed, but the music is definitely like, got my spirits up, so I'm happy about that.
Thank you. We are definitely looking forward to being in community with y'all. We do have our social media information at the bottom that you can see there. So if anything resonates with you all tonight, or if there's any information that you want to reach back out to us to get from us, that's how you can connect us, as well as our email that we'll be providing at the end. So we like to start all of our workshops with virtual space agreements, because it's important for us and it's important for you all over the next hour or so that we create an environment where everyone feels safe and supported to share. We are going to ask a lot of you guys tonight with regards to a vulnerability and just being open and being present with the conversation. And we know sometimes that can be a lot. So our first space agreement is be mindful of your needs. So not only your physical needs, it's dinner time for some people. So feel free to eat, do your thing, get your water, your food, take care of your body, nourish yourself. It's okay. But also your emotional needs. We are going to be talking about self, and anytime we're talking about ourselves, some things may come up. So definitely feel free to just step away from the space. Give yourself permission to do that. Use I statements. I'm looking at 6, 7, 8 unique, very unique people. So in order to honor that uniqueness, speak from your own perspective. And one mic, we're in the Zoom world now, so you know how that works, right?
Right.
But we do, it's a very intimate group tonight, which we like. So there are going to be lots of opportunities. We're going to be like, Sandrine, take yourself off mute and share. And that's how the night is going to flow. Everybody's nodding their head. Okay, cool. I like that. I like the energy. Okay, good. So judgment-free zone, like we said, Sandrine, earlier, this is a space of learning and just uplifting each other. So we're not going to judge each other in a space. That goes right into our sprinkle glitter, not shade. We do this. Can everybody sprinkle glitter on themselves? Lamont, I don't see your glitter fingers. Okay. Sylvia, okay, I don't got it. All right.
Josephine, yes, Linda said, let me put on my camera so I can sprinkle this glitter on myself.
You know, we can't see you. But yeah, so we were sprinkling glitter. We want everybody just to be positive, to be loved upon, because the world is already hard enough. So when we come in these spaces, we just want to make sure it's super positive and progressive. Be present. Y'all could be anywhere. I guess we mostly in New York, so not really. Really be anywhere, but you know, sit right here, right? You might as well be present and just give yourself permission to be a part of this conversation. I promise it's gonna be a really good conversation, and you'll get the most out of it if you really just really be present with the content. Be mindful of intent versus impact. That's just really be open to hearing the impact of the things you say and do, regardless if you meant it in a particular way. So that's super important. Ask for literacy moments. You can certainly say, Timey, what are you talking about? Could you go back? I don't understand. And it'll
what
be okay.
What does that word mean?
I'll say sure.
Yeah. And lastly, and most importantly, anticipate discomfort and lack of closure. We have 60 minutes to talk about a very important and comprehensive topic. So with that being said, there is going to be a lot left unsaid. And we hope and trust that you continue doing the work once we leave this space, because we know that self-care and reflection and resiliency is an ongoing process, right? So if everyone is comfortable and okay with that, can we get an actual thumbs up or a virtual thumbs up so we can make sure everybody's on the same page? Okay. All right, cool. So any questions about our space agreements? Okay, perfect, perfect. So I'm just really quickly gonna go over tonight's vibe. We know that we hate sitting in meetings and we don't know what to anticipate. And when y'all saw the title, y'all probably was like, what exactly does that mean? So I'm gonna kind of explain it to you a little bit. So we just did our introductions and Vicky really went over our why these spaces are important for us, especially at a time like this, where it's so much things to navigate. So we're gonna move into our rituals and our open activity, which we're gonna do some writing. So if you wanna make sure you have a pen and paper, something to write with, for folks who are comfortable with voice recording, if you're in a comfortable laying position, that's fine as well. You can also use your phone to voice record as well. And we're gonna do a little meditation. So for folks who are not used to meditating, this is an opportunity for you to try something new, which is cool, always cool to try new things. So our content for tonight is going to be a part about reflection, a conversation about resilience. And then lastly, we're going to finish up with a reawakening conversation and what that looks like. And we're just going to close with our moment of clarity, which we're going to just kind of go into what we see for ourselves in 2021. Any questions or thoughts or anything about tonight's vibe? Okay, perfect.
Everybody ready to rock and roll? They're like, what you got?
Right, because we, like I said, you know, we're gonna ask a lot. We're gonna ask for a lot of sharing. And you know, since we did the space agreements, everybody's okay. Everybody feels comfortable, right? Y'all gave me the thumbs up, okay? So if I say Sylvia, Yeah, Sylvia's like, I'm ready.
Like, you call me one more time.
So before we jump into our content, we're going to talk about our rituals. Every workshop performance, my partners and I, we always do a ritual to ground ourselves in this work. Our ritual, reforms ritual, is to say affirmations, to say a quote, something to lead us into this space. Today's rituals, today's quote is going to be about from Audre Lorde. Actually, today's her birthday.
So happy birthday, Audre Lorde, and Toni Morrison.
And Toni Morrison's her birthday today. Of course, many of us know she's an American writer, a feminist, a civil rights activist.
Yeah.
She her work, her activism, her publishing speaks and spoke into like the importance of the struggle and resilience for the people who are oppressed in the world. So she's definitely going to lead us into this conversation right now. And the quote we're gonna quote on her today is going to be, it's kind of famous, y'all know it. Self-care, caring for yourself is not self-indulgence, it is self-preservation, it is the act of political warfare. That is the quote for today. We also ask people to drop their affirmations, their favorite quotes in the chat, and we will close our workshop with a closing quote. So if anything saw on Instagram, on an article, something that led you or you felt that this week, drop it in the chat and we'll read it to close us out. We're gonna go into our thought breaker.
So right now we are going to invite you all to grab that pen and paper that, you know, we just asked for a couple minutes ago. And we're gonna really open up our space today with a brain dump. So has anyone ever done a brain dump before? Raise your hand. Okay, good. Linda's like, not me, perfect. So this is gonna be your first time. So we're gonna talk a little bit about what the purpose of it is afterwards. But right now, what we're going to invite you all to do, and if you can be as uninterrupted as possible, it would be best, but we understand life, right? So we're going to give you all 2 minutes to just really write down everything that comes to your mind. And again, if you're not writing, if you want to speak it in a voice note, you can do that as well. But really to take 2 minutes uninterrupted to just dump everything out your brain unapologetically and just without any structure or anything like that. So is everyone ready and understanding what's going to happen right now? Okay, I see some head nods, thumbs up. Okay, cool. Sandra, you ready? Okay, perfect.
All right.
So I'm gonna set the timer for 2 minutes. And if you want, you can turn your camera off for this time just to give yourself, you know, if you don't want people looking at you while you're writing, you know, some people feel uncomfortable about that, whatever. But 2 minutes, and then we're gonna bring you all back to the space and we're gonna kind of chat about it. So I'm gonna set the timer now. And then I will let you all know when the time is up. So you all can start writing, dumping your brain now. All right, all right. Time is up. So you all can come back into the space. Turn your cameras back on so I can see all those beautiful faces. And the first thing I'm going to invite us all to do is to take a deep breath. Okay. So what was that process like for folks? Without not necessarily sharing what you wrote, but what was the process like for you?
Freeing.
Can you share a little bit more about that?
You know, I just lost my mate. You know, he was shot and found in his apartment. And I think
sorry to hear that.
Yeah, so the 3 days that I mourned and then the days after that, I think I did what you're talking about. And I just wrote and dumped everything in a composition book. I filled up the whole book. And in the end of my writing, what I learned and what I wrote today is he's dead. And the truth is I don't even think I'm sad because of that. I think I'm crying for me and the things I put up with.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes. I don't necessarily, I don't see your name. It just has numbers. Can you share your name?
Kim.
Kim, thank you for sharing. And again, we just invite you all to just be as comfortable and vulnerable as possible because that's where the work is. So I appreciate you for sharing that for sure. What would someone else like to share about what the process like was for them? Was like for them, excuse me. Anyone else?
I'll say it was a long 2 minutes. Usually 2 minutes go by fast, like quick, but when you're doing it, and usually we will have music. This time we didn't have music. Mm-hmm. So it seemed much longer than before. But also, I didn't necessarily write any words on my brain dump. Mm-hmm. I just like kind of drew pictures and scribbled out like those feelings, like, you know, all this anxiety or all this, like, you know, the awe of the world in you, kind of scribbled it out on paper. And sometimes, like, I realized the brain dump don't have to be words. It can be just images.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Taimi, thank you for elevating that. So sometimes people think there's a right way to do it, and there is really no right way. It's whatever just actually comes out. So thank you for sharing that. Sandrine, you wanted to add something?
I mean, once I started, I kept going, and then I my main takeaway was, how do I turn it off?
Yeah, that's the part, right? And that's the same thing that we kind of feel and that we experience as we navigate our daily stressors and we navigate, you know, taking care of ourselves. And that's why it's so important to have that hard stop and say, you know what? Now is the time for me to enact some self-care. I've gotten it out, I've put it out on the table, and now it's time for me to take care of myself. So that's definitely a good one. When do I stop? You stop to take care of yourself, right?
Right. Yeah. And just acknowledging mindfulness. The practice of mindfulness is acknowledging our feelings as they come and go and as they pass and being unapologetic about it. So the pain and the weary and the mourning can be a part of those feelings, but also just accepting it and not pushing those feelings to the side. So the brain dump is a really good exercise because we receive a lot of information on a daily basis. And sometimes, you know, it could just really feel like information overload. So the exercise is somewhat of a relief that you can just take a couple minutes to get everything that's in your mind out of your body and put it on paper. So know after the brain dump, you may still have those concerns and thoughts, but in that moment, sometime like Kim said, it may feel a little freeing just to get everything out. Mm-hmm. So thank you all for that process. And it's certainly something that you can do daily. I know a lot of people tell us that after they've come to our workshop, they're like, I do the brain dump every day and I'm Like, it's so helpful. So just, you know, anything that we offer tonight could be certainly something that you could put in your personal toolbox, and you can always reach out to us for any other like questions about anything that we offer to you all tonight.
Mm-hmm. Also, before we move on, this is a great activity for our children. If you have any grandchildren, little people in your life, I know they don't necessarily come out and say things. We ask them, what's going on with you? What's happening with you? And they're like, oh, nothing, I'm fine. This is a great way to have a conversation with your little people. If you have children, grandchildren, or kids, a school, or your participants, it's a great activity to kind of get that dialogue going. So take a picture of it, save it, and use it.
For sure. Thank you for elevating that timing. So piece of our workshops, we like to share an image and get folks to just receive it and digest it, and then just tell us how the image made them feel. So we have something coming up, so take a few minutes just to digest it, and we certainly want to hear from some folks about what's coming up for them. Tell me something's resonating with you.
For me?
Yeah.
Of course, blue, my favorite color, so I like the blue. Duh. I love the blue. But I'm looking at the unfair treatment and systems. I was watching the Black Church documentary last night on PBS, and that like kind of reminded me of like how those systems, church system, government systems, school systems, families, all of them kind of like intersect, and how the unfair treatment was definitely elevated in those systems for Black and Brown people. So that definitely stood out for me.
Okay. What else? Anyone else?
I know for me, what stood out definitely was saying no. And loving myself, because I'm in this profession and because I am just a caring, nurturing person, I always want to be available to everyone. But the fact is that I do have to learn how to create those boundaries and how to say no, and how to just take the time to love up on myself so I can get the rest that I need so I can come back and be the best me that I can be. So that's the one that I definitely would say that I wear it well, but it is very heavy. You know,
Tangerine. Thank you, Vicky.
I love her nails, or their nails. I am just going to say that the blue is rocking for sure. But on a serious note, I noticed that, you know, some of the large circles were, you know, some had hope and some had, you know, pain, and they're about the same size, you know. Pain is equal to fatigue, because, you know, you can have loss, but there's also joy, you know what I mean? And then I also noticed some of the small circles and some of the things that were so, I wear glasses, so I literally had to zoom in. Mm-hmm. And I noticed that love was all the way at the bottom. And I was like, what does that mean, you know? So I that kind of resonated with me, just to know how, you know, so many things go on a day-to-day basis in our lives. And to me, we can all go through so many emotions on a regular basis, and, you know, some high, some low. So, I love the statement across, not be just because I carry it well doesn't mean it isn't heavy.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, Sandrine, I really love your, like, you noticing the size of the circles. Mm-hmm. Like, that was... You know, some of our artists, you know, that we show, we have like the blurb of what they intended to do with the image. And I'm like, now I need to go find the artist and figure out, because I love that. So thank you for that, for elevating that. Linda, you had something to share.
Yes, because I was looking at it similar to Sandrine. That's why you see me looking forward. the shapes and the colors were like, you know, to me, I thought it was like in the descending or ascending order. Mm. So like her, I was like, why is financial worry so small and pain and fatigue is so big? No, I mean, I could understand isolation now in this time of how we're living. And so I begin to look at the sizes and try to put them in different categories. That's what I do. I like order. So my tail chaos excites me. So
okay, what I think,
right?
I saw words.
Thank you, Linda.
And I saw life, and I see choices, and I see yes and no. And I think the isolation, loss, pain, fatigue, all of those things are in big circles because the brain will focus on the negativity the most.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why you gotta guard your mind and your thinking and learn how to change the thoughts.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Kim, that's the spirit of our workshop. And you know, both you and Linda's thought had me thinking when you shared, what would the balls look like in your hand if you had those same, you know, those same words, those same conditions, what would be the size of your balls? Where would they fall? You know, Linda said ascending, descending order, just like consider what it would look like for you. And to Kim's point, which balls are you giving the most energy to?
Yeah.
And which balls you probably need to throw across the street somewhere.
Well, I think right now for the moment, I'm just going with the flow. Like whatever feeling come, I'm going to feel it. And I'm going to be as honest with myself as I possibly can.
Yes.
Allow yourself that grace. That's what I always say. Feel the feels. Lamont, did you want to share something, Lamont?
Sure. So for me, it's looking for the good. And it's not necessarily looking for the good within myself. It's me always looking for the good in other people. And reflecting their energy on something that I might have done, and through trial and error, finding out that it's not me that's the problem. And it's not always you that's the problem, it's the other person.
Good morning.
You know, so I'm working on that. You know, I try to be the best person that I can be and try to be there for others as much as I can be. I think putting others' feelings before mine a lot of times and just to be brought down. So it's just what's doing it for me is looking for the good, you know, because not everyone is good. So it's realizing that and understanding that it's okay to know that there are good people that's out there and there are not good people out there, because a lot of times we mistake the ones that are good for the ones that's not, and we give all this energy to the one that's no good for us.
Mm-hmm.
That's so true.
I feel like that's the part two right there, because I was gonna go off on a tangent, but
hey, I'm like, ooh, you opening some doors right now.
For sure. And I think that just in the content for today, reflection, resiliency, and reawakening, I think that this image just captured all of those different thoughts, being reflective on, you know, who's good for me and who's not, what spaces are good for me and what's not. You know, just all those different things, being able to identify that hope or loving yourself and those different factors that gave you the resiliency to even navigate and survive this past 12 months, right? And then having that reawakening, like, okay, I know all of that to know now what, right? And a very hopeful and progressive thoughts about what can be, right? So we just really wanted to start with this image, and we thank you all for unpacking it so beautifully, because I love it.
I've never heard before, like really concepts I've never heard before. You guys are really out here thinking, reflecting, and we appreciate it. So this is going to be a good workshop. We got some good stuff going on. Let's keep the ball going. So right now, what we want to do, for those of us who may not have the introduction or may not be familiar with meditation, we want to dispel, like I said earlier, we want to dispel the myths. We want to dispel the fact that people feel like, I don't do meditation. What is that? I don't know what that is. And we want to make it easy and attainable and digestible for you all. And so what we have today is we're going to do a grounded meditation, and we're going to use a YouTube channel that's already situated, has many different topics of meditation. You can just pull up on, open it and pick the one that's speaking to you, resonating with you at that particular time. What we're using today is Saleha. Saleha Marie. She does work with, you know, the self and the mindfulness, and then creating these beautiful meditations that we can use. Her voice is so soothing. She speaks to the work in which we're trying to promote. And so we want to introduce that to you today. So this is also an offering. If you've never done meditation, feel free to keep this, share this with a loved one. And we're just going to take the next 4.5 minutes to kind of just listen to the words, kind of center ourselves, get ourselves in a good place. And then we can start to continue the work for this evening. Javaya's going to get us started with that. So feel free, like we mentioned earlier, if you want to keep your camera on, you're totally welcome to do so. If you want to turn off your camera and just kind of do your breaths, you're more than welcome to do so. Ready.
Your breath is something you can always come back to inside of a meditation and in everyday life. So if you're trying to meditate and your thoughts get all crazy, you can always come back to your breath. So I'm going to teach you my favorite breathing technique, which is called four-part breathing. And you can use this breath inside and outside of a meditation. You can use it inside of a meditation to get you centered and lifted, or you can use it in everyday life if you feel like your frequency is shifted, or somebody said something to you that you don't like, or someone cuts you off in the supermarket. You know, this is a breath you can use to shift you so you can respond from a higher level, right? Before every meditation in this mixtape, we will do a four-part breath to get centered, but I'm going to teach it to you here, so if you ever need to listen to it by itself for any reason, you can do that too. I'm going to direct you to send air to four parts of your body: your stomach, your chest, your neck, and your head. I know, you can't send air to your head and your neck, but we're going to focus on allowing and making it so you can intention to imagine that air is being sent to these areas of our body. And when you breathe in, I want you to breathe in, imagine like a balloon filling up with air, so that when we breathe in, we become full of breath and not like sucking in super inflated, because that's not a strong breath. When you do this four-part breath, it's best to have your spine in alignment. You can sit in lotus or half lotus pose, or you can just simply sit on a chair. Whatever feels intuitively good to you. So just take a big, deep breath in and out. Now breathe into your stomach, to your chest, to your neck, to your head. Hold. And release from your head, from your neck, from your chest, from your stomach. Breathe in again to your stomach, to your chest, to your neck, to your head. Hold. And release from your head, from your neck, from your chest, from your stomach. One last four-part breath. Breathe in to your stomach, to your chest, to your neck, to your head. Hold. And release from your head, from your neck, from your chest, from your stomach.
right, we welcome everyone to take a deep breath. Welcome yourselves back to your screens. Would anyone like to share about their 4.5 minute meditation experience?
I'll share.
Sure, thank you.
Hi, again, I'm Rydell Harris, one of the community liaisons with Amita Care. For me, meditation comes in many different forms. This form here, I feel like every other year, whether it was school or a job or some type of play or dance or choreography that I used to do, there was always someone to bring in the meditation to center. And I feel like everything happens for a reason. So whatever chaos is going up here, because I'm a Virgo and my mind never stops going, it's like, okay, it was needed at that moment in time. So it was like, perfect. I needed that. So it was just something that came to mind.
Thank you.
Sharing.
So are you talking about like elementary school or like middle school? Like what, the whole, every time? That's awesome.
Elementary school, now there has been either a teacher, a counselor, some type of role model, some type of just responsible adult that just came in, just how you guys did randomly. Mm-hmm. And like, let's meditate real quick. Mm-hmm. And it was, you know, like for me, music soothes the savage beast in my head. So that's also another method to do so.
Love it.
Yeah, so we definitely like to introduce this form of meditation, but we also like to elevate that you don't necessarily have to sit cross-legged and listen to soft music for you to be able to meditate. There are a lot of different forms of meditation. Me, myself, I probably couldn't do this form as a general practice, but what I can do is I listen to a series of affirmations in the morning in the shower. As a part of my meditative practice. Mm-hmm. So just really finding different methods that fit your lifestyle and make sense in your life. So really that was 4.5 minutes of just mental peace and just really figuring out what ways you can incorporate 4.5 minutes of mental peace throughout your day, whether it's through a song or listening to Shayla do her thing.
Mm-hmm. I definitely do the same thing, Javanya, like you're saying. I actually do my grounded meditations in the evening. For me, it allows me to do it while I'm in bed and I'm ready to go to sleep. So it's a sleep meditation that I do using an app, Better Me, that has a very calming, soothing male voice on there. So dark and rich. And it just really puts me in a place to go to sleep. But then in the morning, I don't need that particular voice. So I do, right. So in the morning, I do different sets of affirmations as well. Right from YouTube as well. For me, I do a Bob Baker. So I like his voice. I don't know why, but I love to listen to that. And there's different categories as well and different topics. So you all could also, work that into your daily routine. So if you're looking for money and abundance and prosperity, there's an affirmation for that. If you're looking for love, if you're looking for friends, there's an affirmation for that. So find the one that speaks to you and utilize that in your daily schedule. It'll change you.
And we also have some apps that we'll be sharing at the end.
Yeah.
Because we understand that some of this stuff might be super foreign to a lot of people, from self-care to even meditation, but there are a lot of different resources that are available to you so that you could start to develop and learn your own practices and whatever makes sense for you in your life. So it's not TV stuff, it's reality that makes sense for you, right?
Right.
The pictures
always get me. It's always
I changed the picture. This is a new one, right?
This is funny. The other one was good too, but this picture really talks about exactly how exhausted it's been for the past year for many of us, right? Me trying to not catch COVID-19, navigate working from home during the pandemic, teach and raise children, connect with teachers, fight for social and racial justice, ignore the social media trolls, maintain a social life, drink enough water, exercise, and stay sane. This is happening on a daily basis.
And that's the short list, we always say, right? That's
right, it is. It is the short list, right? But and so many of this is happening on our daily basis. And are we taking the time to really reflect? Are we taking the time to just pause and kind of reflect about what's happening with our daily lives?
So the first portion of our content is the reflection piece. And I hope y'all got that pen and paper ready because we are going to do another activity. We like tangible stuff, you know, things that y'all can do. Because again, this is the work for you all. We are not the experts on anyone's lives. Yep. Reform Consulting is not coming in saying you do X, Y, and Z, you won't be stressed out tomorrow. Because
we'll probably
get paid a lot of money if we were able to do something like that, right? But right. No one can. So listen, this is the work that you all have to do for yourselves. And the first part of that is the reflective piece. So right now we're going to invite you all to draw a body.
Anybody. You want to draw a body, you want to draw any figure that you see that you feel comfortable, and you want to make it as empty and hollow as you see here. So follow the example. I always give my body a small waist.
Legs. My body will have some braids. Don't worry about it.
That's what my body looks like. A small waist and let's small see. Legs.
Don't get real. You know, this is not Picasso. This is not an art contest.
Not we at all.
I want you to draw something. It could be a stick figure as well. It doesn't necessarily have to look like this. But when you got your body drawn up, let us see it. Lamon, let us see your body. Let us see that. Let us see what you've got for us, because this is a really reflective exercise that we love doing.
It's my favorite.
Kim, let us see your body. For folks who are off camera, I hope and trust that y'all got y'all bodies drawn up. Okay, perfect, Kim. Thank you. Linda, you got it? Okay, perfect. Okay, Linda. Timey, okay, you got, you always put hair on yours. You kill me with that. What is your name? C. Posella. Okay, I love it. Okay, got the curls on it. Okay, perfect, perfect. Okay, so we are going to be moving into the prompts for the activity. Okay, Lamon, I see you.
Like, I want to
have more than one person. This is a self-reflective activity. Other people can't be on your paper. Or am I seeing stuff? Okay, never mind. Okay, so our first prompt is write your sources of stress. So indicate somewhere on your paper near your body your sources of stress. The things that you find are stressing you out. Again, this is an introductory activity. So we recognize that we won't necessarily have enough time to do in its full entirety, but please take the activity and the prompts and continue to develop it outside of today, because it can be very beneficial and helpful for you. And also we won't be asking you to share your body. So don't worry about what you're writing. Like, I ain't showing in my body all of this stress. Don't worry about it.
It's none of our business.
It's for you. It's not for me. So maybe some things that have come up in a brain dump, maybe could be similar things that are coming up now for you when you're thinking about your sources of stress. And we promise we are not intending to stress y'all out with this activity. Levon is like, I was good until you asked me to think about it. I promise it's okay. Okay, so I see some folks still writing, so we're gonna give it a second or two. Sandrine's ready, okay. All right, Linda's ready, Kim's ready. Okay, our second prompt is indicate on your body where stress shows up. So your symptoms of stress. So if you get headaches, if you get a clenched jaw, if you know your symptoms of stress indicated on your body. Okay, Rondell's looking up to me. And folks off camera, you can certainly just give me a thumbs up so that I know you are present and following. I don't want to make sure you all are good too. Okay, cool, thank you. Everybody's good with that second prompt? Okay, and our last prompt is indicate how you cope with your stress. So what do you do to navigate, to cope, to handle, to deal with your stressors? If you write, maybe circle your hands. If you sing, indicate on your mouth area that you sing, listen to music, whatever you do to cope with stress. I know, Tommy, you needed a deep breath after that one. No. I was going to invite us to take another deep breath because breaths are important and we don't always recognize how often we aren't breathing. I mean, you know, we're breathing because we're alive, but deep breathing, that pause breathing, okay?
It's interesting because I was like, didn't realize I was holding my breath in.
Yeah.
Writing this down.
I'm going to use that example because ever since our workshop where somebody shared that, I share that all the time because it was so revealing that she shared that. It was so perfect. So I'm going to invite everyone to take a deep breath now. Rondell, I don't see you breathing. Okay. I hope you're breathing. Okay. Okay. So, you know, we like to start with just a reflection on the process. So how is the process for folks? Mm-hmm. Cynthia, are you sharing? We're not. Put her on mute. Okay, so what was the process like for folks? Identifying your stressors, identifying how it shows up in your body, then identifying what you do about it. What was that like? Was it hard? Was it like, oh, I probably should do this more often? Sandrine's like, I knew already. Here, Sandrine, tell us. Tell the people how you do it.
I don't know. I just wrote it. It just came. I just knew where it was and what was happening. I said, well, if you know, now you know. It's all right there.
Okay.
It helped me realize a couple of things that I wasn't sure about just because I thought about it, I guess. So I was like, that does bother me, or I just need to do this because, you know, I'm stressed, or the meditation part was good.
The massage in my head.
Oh my God.
I'm sorry. I took care of it. Lamond, you wanted to share? Thanks. I want to say C. Is that okay? Because I'm like, that's
Carmen. Yes.
Carmen. Okay. Yeah. Carmen. Thanks, Carmen. Lamond, go ahead.
I will say I have been dealing with my stress a lot better than what I used to. And it was just a collaboration of things that's helping me with that. Like, you know, I go back to, you know, when I was in school, you know, working on my psychology degree, it's helped me a lot to deal with stress. And because I don't know why, but I'm that person that overthinks things. I overthink everything, you know, and it bothers me. Like, even when I try to not think about it, I'm thinking about it, you know. Being in this pandemic, a lot of ways that I used to handle stress was I would just go to the gym, you know, have a good workout. And, you know, it was a combination, gym and music. Normally listening to music that identifies to what emotions I'm feeling at that time. But the gym was the number one for me. And now, you know, with the lapse of being able to get out to the gym and stuff like that, you know, and being stuck in the house, it kind of renders those stressors that you thought that you got rid of or kind of under control, are kind of like trying to seep back in, you know, but it really is an eye opener withdrawing the body and looking at the different stressors that I deal with on a daily basis that I really shouldn't, you know, but it's helping me identify them more since I'm writing it down on paper instead of thinking about it, you know, writing it down. So I think this is going to help me identify it and like nip it in the bud when before it even caused any problems with me personally.
I love it. Because that's exactly what this reflection piece is about. It's taking the opportunity to interrogate your lifestyle and see how you're living and how you're moving through. That's one of the things that we promote here at Reform Consulting. We're not the experts of your life, so we're not going to be able to tell you when things are effectively working for you or when they're efficient for you. Only you will be able to determine that. So it is important for us to take that time and take stock and do the interrogation that we need to do to see what are some things that we can leave behind. What are some things that are not necessarily important to us at this particular time? And what are some things that we can actually start to spend more engaging times with, right? And so once we are able to compartmentalize that, it's a little bit easier to navigate. Because even though we're thinking about so many things, they don't all need to be thought about, to be quite honest with you, right? We need to operate in the present, as we mentioned in our, in our room agreements. Being present also in your life is something that you also can enact. You know, being present in the spaces that you're in, the meetings that you're in, the conversations that you're having, that requires you to also be present as well. So take that, use that, and implement it into your life.
Yeah, and it's really the awareness piece as well, because what I also heard Lamont share is that if this activity had been done 12 months ago, it would have looked much different. So just being able to understand that our body, our physical body, but also our body in this activity is going to change as well due to like different circumstances as we continue to navigate unforeseen and uncertain circumstances. So we definitely thank you for sharing that, because it just goes right into, you know, how we unpack this activity that was mine a long time ago. But when we asked the question about what are your sources of stress, Vicky definitely shared being able to look at what you indicated on your body and start to distinguish between what can I control and what can I control. And I know we probably heard that so much over the past year, but just really think about what that means, right? Like looking at your body, what are those things you can't control and what you can? And also we like this part of the activity because it's also acknowledging that everybody is dealing with different stuff, right? At any given time. So that not only means giving yourself grace, but giving others grace, because like our earlier image showed us people walking around with some heavy stuff going on, whether we know it or not. And quite frankly, it's not our business, right? Whoa. It's just that we have to move with the understanding that people going through some stuff, right? The whole body piece, that beginning was just to really elevate that you are stressed, but what are some things that you can get rid of, compartmentalize, and things like that.
And some things that you're also already doing really well, right? Let's not forget that as well. The third prompt was, what are some things that you're already doing?
I was like, wait, what are you guys doing the second one yet? You want to go to the third one yet? Oh, first?
What? Yeah. Yeah. So once we identify, once our sources are stressed are, and we start to see how it's showing up in our body, and that was the picture that you saw there, just different thoughts, different things, different images that kind of happen in our body, and it starts to show up. We like to present this quadrant and kind of see where does stress show up in your body. If it wasn't something that was evident as you did the mind-body mapping activity, where are some other areas within this quadrant that stress does show up in your body, and what does the symptoms look like? Right. We're not always able to identify it, but that hunger that you feel, right, that is attributed to the stress, because you just did not allow yourself to get up and move today. You did not allow yourself to get up and eat today and take care of your needs, right? When we have that emotional stress that shows up and we just have this overwhelming feeling of feeling down and that downtrodden, what are we doing to kind of check into that, bring that awareness and find that balance in our lives that we need to have in order to change that mood, right? And have a channel changer, as I like to call them, a channel changer. I need to change the channel. I don't like what's going on. So let me change this channel.
So yeah, what did you all do? For what are your symptoms of stress? What are some of y'all symptoms? Did y'all know? Let you know, did y'all indicate it on y'all body? Like what happened? Did y'all put your headache? Like what, if you feel comfortable sharing, like how did you draw your symptoms of stress on your body?
My symptoms looks like the Charlie Brown shirt with the things across the lines across it. That was across the head.
Okay.
You know, because I heard what Jackie was saying, or what Lamont was saying earlier, and what Rydell was saying earlier about, you know, just overthinking. And then I literally just started drawing a big circle around the stomach area because I increase that appetite and I just stress eat. And I was like, well, that's what happens. That's where all my stress is.
It does show up there, right? And also, I mean, you know that our stomach holds a lot of good and bad bacteria. So also putting all that food on there also relates to our feelings. So if we're eating a lot more processed foods, we're eating a lot more sugar, our body is going to start actually feeling weighed down. So we have to pay attention to that. And this brings awareness to that. Anyone else that stress showing up in their body, where does it show up for you? I know for me, it's always in my shoulders. I got to remind myself, put your shoulders down. Carrying tension, put your shoulders down, right? But anybody else, is stress where is stress showing up in your body?
Sylvia, you wanted to share? I got you. Hold on. Hold on. Let me take you off mute.
Sorry. I have some stuff going on, but I was listening the whole time, and I have to leave. I have another event I have to attend. But with stress showing up in my around the edges of my hair, my hair growth is suffering over here, and I don't have no braids or anything pulling it, but I know my stress factors. I'm gonna have my forehead is gonna be in the back.
Oh no, we don't want that, Sylvia.
We brought an awareness today, and that's the most important thing. Now is the time for you to do the work, interrogate your lifestyle, and see what are the causes of stress and what are the things that you can start to eliminate out your life, and what are the things that you can start to add and introduce to your life to help you combat the stress that you're having. So we're not going to let that forehead go back.
No, we don't want that, Sylvia. Okay. No.
Yeah.
I want to elevate.
It's not cute.
I definitely want to elevate the conversation.
Stay tuned for the next slide, because that's where you're going to fit in. Okay, Sylvia?
Right.
Many of our stresses that we put down on paper, some of them are positive stress. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, us having employment, you know, work is crazy, but we get to go to work and do what we love, and we get to, you know, make a difference in this world. Some people are maybe in school may stress them out. So like them getting to that finish line of like having a diploma or that degree to make, you know, their lives better. Or even like for output, for my situation, just balancing, you know, having, you know, just more work. And it's good because we're moving towards what we wrote down in our affirmations in the beginning of the year. We want to have, growth in different areas that may require more of a heavier lift. So like some of the things that we're definitely experiencing is stressful, but it's positive stress. It's positive stress. So just not all stress is like bad stress. So I want us to, like, to think about those things too.
Yeah, that's great timing. Yeah, that's a great point. I love adding just the factors about positive stress and just changing our relationship we have with stress, because we know that stress is gonna happen. So this is just another image. If your body ended up looking like this, this is just another way for you to capture how stress may show up in your body. Because a lot of times we may not know. So that headache that lasted 3 weeks is probably not a headache.
That's definitely stress.
Going on.
That difficulty in swallowing, that inability to speak for yourself, right? That the words just choking up. That might also have something to do with you just not checking into your chakra. So you might want to look into that as well. The trembling, the sweat palpitations. I always say, I don't know if you guys remember the commercial the degree had, where the young lady was going to ask her boss for a promotion, and she was in the bathroom under the dryer like this because of the stress sweat. It was positive stress, but, right? But it was still stress sweat. So we want to be mindful and pay attention and bring that awareness to our bodies, because our bodies are going to tell us. It's like a dashboard of a car. The same way that you know that you are empty, you need more gas, you need to refuel. The same way that you know that your oil's not hot, don't take off yet. Your body is a clear indicator of what is manifesting and what's happening when you allow this stress to really live and permeate within your body. So that's why we put up this image. I love this image here, because it's just awareness that we never really had. Like, I didn't know my lack of appetite also led to is a cause of stress, right? Is a direct derivative of stress. So the issues that I'm having with sleeping, even the vision blurry issues, like those could be attributed to stress. So just navigating that, bringing the awareness to it. And like I keep mentioning, finding the balance. Where is the balance?
Thank you, for sure. So definitely we can share this image with anyone who wants to have it afterwards. And then the last prompt was how you cope with stress, right? So now that we understand our sources of stress, we know where it shows up in the body, what do we do about it, right? So we introduced this lifestyle checklist. So at the bottom, it does say negative and positive self-care behaviors, but we always like to elevate the point that anything could be negative or positive, depending on how it shows up in your life. So just really being able to look at this image and maybe see if some of the things that you see here are aligned with some of the things you put on your body paper earlier, or if you're doing some of these things, it was like, oh, I didn't know I cope with stress in that way. Just really being aware of it. So what is coming up for folks? Did you not add the things that you're doing? Did you forget you cope with stress in that way? What's coming up?
Coffee over here and the positive stress for me.
Right. I mean, listen, stress shows up all different types of ways. So, I mean, I'll start it off. I'll definitely start it off and I'll say, this definitely happened to me the other day, but I mean, I'm alone. I live alone. So it wasn't toward anyone, but I had to scream. I literally had to scream. My sink and my bathroom toilet, they broke at the same time. The level of stress that I was just experiencing at that moment, I literally had to scream at the top of my lungs just to get it out. I had to. And I don't necessarily view that as being negative. I needed that release. Right. I couldn't get to the gym. I there was no way that I was going to do a workout. But at that moment, I could scream. I could have an angry outburst. But it wasn't directed towards anybody, but it was a release that I needed for myself. So I know how it showed up for my body, and I know how I actually coped with it. So like we said, there is no negative or positive, because anything could be negative or positive. But how does it show up for you, and how does it resonate with you is more important.
Any thoughts or questions or anything jumping out to folks from this image? How y'all feeling about how y'all cope with stress? Everybody's okay? All right, so we could just leave now then. Go ahead.
I feel, so for me, I drew the big Hero 6 guy, you know, the big balloon guy.
Okay.
Because right now I feel fat and I'm like, I need to be shirt off for the summer. So even when people
say, positive, still wear your shirt off.
You have your shirt off.
But you know how you see yourself in your mirror, in the mirror, and you know where you want to see, where you want to be. Sure. That's sure. Besides the thousand of stress that we're all going through, just to take it back to the ball image, I felt like that was New York City. And if you move that image from region to region on the map, the sizes of the balls will get different for where they're.
Wow. Yes.
And that was same for people and like family members. So something that I'm going to take back to our members and to people in my personal life and people that I sign on into a Medicare, because they kind of go tangent and go off left when we're doing enrollments, and they're just like, oh, they might want to get something off their chest of why are they joining a Medicare in the first place? This is one of the questions we ask them. This can be a little bit of a small little icebreaker within that, the little stressors that they're going through. Because they immediately tell us, they immediately tell me, I need to leave that plan because this is happening and I know your plan is going to be what I need. So this de-stressing, and I can just let them know this exercise, if you know your social media handles, that'll be perfect.
Yes. For sure. And we also have other resources that we could certainly send
you. Question real quick.
Yeah, one second, Kim. But we certainly have like a self-care checklist that we could send you that is really helpful for anyone, but certainly something that you could share with your participants. So we'll definitely drop that in the chat before we're done. So thank you for sharing that. Kim, what you got for us? I'm interested.
Is this like every week that we do this? Because I didn't even know how I got to do this. I just signed in.
Is that a good or bad, Kim? I'm not sure.
No, it's good.
It was divine intervention, Kim. It was divine.
It must have been. Yeah,
Amita Care hosts amazing workshops, everything from fitness and mental health and wellness to nutrition. So there's a gamut of different things that's happening all the time. And we are a reoccurring prospect of that, Amita Care prospect. So you'll see us again. We'll be back. If you're looking for us,
can you do stuff on chakras? So
we actually have a partner that actually does Reiki readings. That we can connect you to.
I love that.
Yeah, so Kim, we'll talk. We'll definitely talk. We'll go on more because we have information that we can share. But yes, we are here to really, again, introduce the conversation, curate the conversation, so that you can really have the conversation with yourself. We always say this, the hardest person for you to lie to is you. So when you really start to think about it and you really start to do the work, that's really what we want to introduce, just ways to do this work, ways to pay attention, ways to bring awareness. And then how do we introduce the balance and the connection in our lives? So we're just going to continue with this conversation so we can get to our moment of clarity. And we may not all achieve it at the same time, but we will be working towards it. Our next portion is to be talking about the resiliency, right? We've already had some time to really look at the reflection. We're taking stock into what's happening in our lives. We're interrogating the ways that stress are showing up and what we're doing to cope with them. And now we're saying, you know what? I have been able to manage. It's been a difficult year, but I've been able to make it.
I did that.
Right? I did. That was all me. I was shooting in the gym, not really in the gym, but it was all me. Right. So if we think about it, and we have here, as we introduce our resilience portion, plot twist, 2020 has actually been the best year of your life. You faced challenge after challenge, you've adapted and you've overcome. 2020 has forced you to grow exponentially. Don't take that for granted. Right. And that's exactly that purview that we talk about. It's so easy to focus on the negative, but when we take time, we can see the positives within, you know, the chaos and within the mess. So that's just a reminder and how we're going to introduce this resilience portion of the conversation, because many of us had to become resilient, right? Many of us had to tap into different things to help us keep going for the next day. And so as we navigate that, we want to introduce an opportunity for you all to talk to each other. We've done a lot of talking. We put a lot of information out there. And so now what we're going to do is introduce Breakout Room. What you see here is pair share reflections. And these are different questions that we just want to have you bring into a breakout room and have that conversation with. So we're asking that you take a picture, because it's a little hard to see it once you're in the room. So take a picture so that you can reflect back to it, revert back to it when it's time. And then we're going to break you up in a little bit. And then you're going to discuss, what are your personal strengths? What are some things that you know that you do well, that is a true talent and a skill that you don't have to pay anybody for, because it's a God-given right, right? And then who's the most resilient person that you know? It can't be Beyonce, because you don't really know Beyonce. So let's be real here. Let's really think into our categories, into our wheelhouses. Who are some people that we know specifically are some people that we find resilient? What do you think are some characteristics of resilient people? So that's just some food for thought.
And we don't have much time, and we definitely want to honor the time, you know, that you all dedicated to tonight. So it's going to be a short conversation with your partner, but certainly if you could get one or two words out and just really share one of the questions, whatever, whichever one comes up for you, just so you all can just have that brief moment to do that. So it's going to be about 3 minutes, not anything long, because yeah, we do have to finish up. So we're going to do that now. And hopefully folks who are not on camera, y'all are able to still share and talk with folks, because y'all know Zoom, nothing worse than getting in the breakout room looking at yourself for 3 minutes. Listen, it happens, okay?
Yes, I've been there.
Maybe I'll just do more than two people in a room, just in case.
Yes, please do. All right.
Okay, so you should see the invitation now. All right. Sandrine, you still here? Let me get you up out of here. All right, that's fine. We can do it with each other, Sandrine. And Cynthia, Santiago. Take yourself off mute, Sandrine.
I didn't even realize.
It's all good. Uh-oh. Let me move, Linda.
Thank you.
Lamont, you look like somebody I know. I'm gonna put my finger on it, like for real.
We know him, T. And Jermaine, we know him. You know him.
It's like really, I know we've seen you at the school when we did a media care last time. That's not what I'm talking about. It's like from somewhere else. Like, unless you look like somebody, you know, they say we all got a twin.
I know, right?
I'm gonna figure it out. I'm gonna let you know. So thank you all for sharing. I think some folks, I hope folks were able to at least get a couple words out.
Right? Yeah, I think my group, we all three of us got to speak, which was really good. So that was dope.
Okay. What were your thoughts? What happened with the conversation? What came up? Was there any themes that resonated with everyone with regards to resiliency and strengths?
One, I'm just going to jump in. I think Miss Josephine is now my best friend, and she's who I think is most resilient, doing what she does at home every day with and for her kids. So I'm nominating her as who I think is the most resilient, because she, we just had like the most amazing conversation. She's so bright in spirit.
Oh, and she,
you know, when somebody can talk about all the stuff that they're doing and still just make you laugh, and you know, the whole time, that's amazing. Mm-hmm. She's doing it with a smile.
Dang, Josephine, I want to hear it too now.
Josephine said we'll be here all night. That's the resiliency piece. Josephine, take yourself off mute. We want to hear you.
Yes, that's me.
Don't be shy now.
You see, I'm still laughing and smiling. Yes, this is one of mine. Say hi.
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 That's so, my oldest son. This is my second oldest son.
Hey, son.
This is my daughter. Come here.
The babies on the Zoom one day because they need to be a part of these.
Right, they do. They do.
Listen, they do. I have one of them. He's on my plan. And his name is Sean Boyce.
Well, tell him to come to the next Amita Care workshop and all the Amita Care workshops.
That's one of my daughters,
Josephine.
Hey, Josephine got a full family over there. Josephine, so that's why you're so resilient. Right, that's where the resiliency comes from. We're seeing them now in actual real time.
This is my last one. Say hi, Sean.
Hi. Hey, Sean.
Thank you, Josephine, for sharing. We appreciate that. We see where the resiliency comes from and grows. Being a mother of five is no easy feat. We thank you for everything.
But I'm doing everything for them, because you know certain parents, they don't take care of their kids.
No, they do not. So give you your flowers while you are here and can receive them. Thank you so much again for sharing. Anyone else just want to kind of talk about what was spoken in their group or what question really resonated for them that they answered?
My group, they were saying one person talked about their mom, the other person talked about their sister. And for me, like, it's just me. Like, I don't really care for people in my family. I don't like them too much. So it's really Oprah and other people and Ayanna. Those are my heroes, because they raised me.
Thank you for sharing. Yeah. Resilience, right, it's an example, and whoever is providing that example to you is the one that you can look up to, right? You want to make sure that you have people in your life that you can emulate the goodness that you see in them, the greatness that you see in them. So if it is Oprah, go ahead, Team Oprah. Listen, I'm all Oprah all the time, okay? Listen. But we thank you for sharing, and we appreciate the share. So just in interest of time, we're going to keep the conversation kind of flowing. We could really be here all night.
Yeah. I don't want us to I don't want us to neglect
the reawakening.
The actual content, the actual image, because there's a lot to unpack here. So we're not gonna go through that. Yeah. But really the last piece is just the reawakening piece, and just really after you have that awareness, that understanding, you understand that you have strengths to be resilient, to navigate whatever crisis or chaos comes up, right? What does that look like? And how are we prioritizing that work? How are we prioritizing that version of ourselves, right? So in 2021, self-care is important. It's super paramount and powerful. And what we have is just to finish up with just a bingo that really captures some of the many ways that you all may have been taking care of yourselves or could be taking care of yourselves, right? And being radical about it. And the middle one is rest, because that takes a lot of radical thinking to know that some days you don't have to do anything but just be and be present, just be alive. And as a Black person, just be Black, right? I can see that. And sometimes we have to give ourselves permission for that. So in the spirit of Audre Lorde on her birthday, right, we're gonna talk about radical self-care. And just if you know how to play bingo, once you see yourself getting bingo, four across, four down, however you find yourself, horizontal. Yell bingo, and celebrate yourself. Bingo.
Bingo.
Amy, you always get bingo first. I'm going to beat you this time.
We don't have no prizes. It's you the prize.
I got bingo.
Okay, time.
I got bingo.
Tell us how you got bingo. Share.
The top row across, I rest. I attended therapy. I celebrated and it was joy. I wrote in my journal twice this week and I left.
Okay.
I got bingo. Mine across.
Linda said I got bingo. Listen,
Linda. I always take.
Go ahead, Linda.
I always take deep breaths because I've got Apple phone and on it it says breathe. So that's what I got. I connect with my community a lot. I do a lot of things. I'm on my community board. I'm on everything at my church. I have mentor children. I like kids. So connection with the community is like my inner self. Uh-huh. I never, right? I try to eat well. I know I'm a bit fatty, but I'm old.
Positive body image.
Right? But positive. I nourish my body. I like to cook. I cook for myself and I try to cook for myself.
As you should.
And I set boundaries where I know, look, if you are being stressed or you're stressed, you stay over there. I keep my little space there. And that be my
protect your space. It's so important. Protect your space.
I love it.
You don't understand how essential that is. Protect your space. Do not give anybody free space in your head. That rent free, no way. Rent is too expensive. So as we just get ready to wrap up, we do, as we mentioned, we do have just some 10 apps that you really want to tap into. You don't have to follow them. We're not being paid by anyone to promote them. The first one actually is Reform Consulting. That's one of the best self-care apps that you want to just pay attention to and you want to just focus on. That is us. But just again, just look at a couple of these 10 apps to kind of cultivate your self-care, taking care of yourself, doing what you have to do, getting a daily reminder of how bad you are. You are the baddest thing walking and you better believe it and you better work. Yeah, that's one of our favorite apps. That's number six, Selfish Babes. That's the one you get in the middle of the day, like, oh, I know I needed that, but yes, you know what? I am a bad chick. Okay.
I'll take a picture.
Yeah, and Shine and Liberation Meditation. Also, Black Faces, Black voices behind them. A lot of these apps don't really speak to us and our people, and it doesn't sound like people that sound like us. So tap into these Black-owned apps as well, and really just and do it for yourself. Take the time, do it for you.
And if you haven't had an opportunity to, we will share this image and it is on our social media, but this is the work. This is in a nutshell, the things that build your resiliency and also will help you navigate all of those things. And we are done and it's 7:31, we are over. So we wanna honor and respect your time. If you have to leave, we understand, we apologize. But this is the end. Vicky or Time, you want to read that?
Yeah, I'll take us out. So mentally picture yourself radiant, strong, successful, happy, full of joy, and full of life. See yourself moving upwards. Leave behind the darkness and confusion into an increasing brightness and loveliness. see yourself progressing, growing, and winning at everything that you do. A moment of clarity. So we can't thank you guys enough for being here and being in community with Reform Consulting. As we mentioned earlier, this is not our first time doing work with the MediCare, and we will be back. I think they like us. We will be back. So look out for more workshops from us, variant topics. And if you have something that you want to discuss, we will curate that conversation for you. Send it over to Sandrine and her team, and we'll make that definitely happen. Sandrine team, we can't thank you enough. The MediCare team, you guys are always amazing.
Thank you.
We thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you guys so much. Thank everyone. I thank everyone for coming out tonight. Tonight's event was sponsored by City Council Majority Leader Lori Cumbo. We want to give her a big thank you for just opening up this event. For having Reform in the house, the whole Reform Consulting team, Javanya, Taimi, Vicky, we love you guys so much and we appreciate all the knowledge you have dropped. I wish there was more time for sure, but we do hope to have you guys back very soon so we can continue this great self-care conversation. And we truly appreciate you. We appreciate the team over at Majority Leader Cumbo's office, Tahira, and the entire MediCare team as well that ensured that this event happened tonight. And we picked a good snowy night here in New York, so we needed a good pick-me-up. So thank you everyone for joining us. And if you haven't signed in via your email or via the Zoom app, which is connected to your email, please drop your email in the chat. We'd like to send you a small token of our appreciation to your email. So definitely just drop it in the chat right now. And we will definitely be thankful to you for participating with us tonight. And we appreciate you all, guys. Stay safe, stay well, and be blessed.
Sandrine, I want you to just tell the councilwoman for me, thank you, and to say hello to Tahira for me.
I will do. I definitely will do. Thank you so much, okay. Linda.
Thank you too. You. Thanks, all the girls.
I was going to say, there's no quotes in the chat. That's okay.
I don't know if I've seen any.
No, that's all right. It's all right. But thank you all.